They sailed to ports that were controlled by rebels, port cities that saw heavy bombardment and fighting and faced near riot-like conditions. They ferried over 3,000 people fleeing a war, housed, fed, and gave them medical attention. These are the Navy's Yemen heroes.
From the stars who steered us home to the man at the helm, the Chief of Naval Staff, Admiral Dhawan, thank you so much, sir, for talking to us. It's been a really testing time for Operation Rahat in terms of all three of the ships, INS Sumitra, still there. But the testing time in terms of what's happening in Yemen, the Saudi coalition is bombing the Houthi rebels. You have to take permissions to go in. You sometimes have to use craft. There is a lot of consensus that has to be built. But it's been a brilliant operation, sir.
Well, I like to say that it's important to understand that every ship of the Indian Navy, when it deploys on an overseas deployment, is geared to take on the task of humanitarian assistance and disaster relief. I think that is what saved the day. And therefore, the other part, which is good planning. So before the operation actually unfolded, there was a lot of planning which went on at naval headquarters. We had our war rooms activated. We got the details of the various ports. We were in touch with the Ministry of External Affairs, Ministry of Defense. And I think it was very well coordinated
and
as to what
time was
timing and time was very important. And therefore, when the Ministry of Defense and External Affairs decided that the ship needed to get deployed, actually it was INS Sumitra, which was on a Gulf of Aden patrol. And I think that indicates the importance of the footprint of the Indian Navy. That indicates the importance of being flexible and maneuverable, and the ability of our ship's companies, the officers and sailors, to switch on from one task to another with ease. And when the orders came in, actually Sumitra was there, and she was the first respondent to bring out the Indians. And as the instructions had been given to the ships, that our ships will remain deployed till the last Indian is evacuated safely back home.
And that's what's happened. INS Sumitra now again back on her anti-piracy duties. Sure. But now, the almost warlike conditions that the ships were going through, and yet they had to make sure that non-combatants were safe, brought on board, and then brought to Djibouti and back home, which is another leg of it.
This is a very important task of the Navy, which we call our benign role, because we have to be very careful that this is an operation which is for humanitarian assistance. We are out there to help the men, women, children, the old people, not only Indian nationals. Because though we evacuated 3,074 people, 1,783 were Indians, and 1,291, over 30 countries at least, were from other countries. And I think, again, I would repeat that our sailors, our officers, did an outstanding job in going beyond the call of their duty and displaying what we always learn, service before self. And they gave up their personal comfort. It was, yes, as you said, warlike conditions. They had to take some very quick snapshot decisions. And while the operations room at Delhi, the headquarters, West Naval Command, were manned, it was the man on the spot, that is the commanding officer and his crew, who had to be in touch with us and take some very swift decisions.
Admiral, thanks so much for speaking to us. And in your language, as they say, Bravo Zulu.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, sir.
Thank you.